I've gone through all your comments from 41 Retopology videos and found 462 questions. Here are the top 50 most frequently asked questions about the topic of retopology. Number 1. Why is retopology critical in 3D modeling and animation? Retopology makes sure the mesh can bend well during animation, makes rendering faster, and even helps with texturing by enabling you to create a nice UV unwrap of your model. Should retopology be done for game assets and architecture as well as character models? Yes, retopology is important for all assets to ensure they are optimized for performance and can be animated or interacted with properly. What is the best approach for muzzle structure topology in 3D models? Use edge loops that follow the natural flow of the muzzles. This allows the mesh to deform in a lifelike way. How to choose the right way of topology for different parts of a 3D model? Well, the right topology depends on the model's needs. Use more loops in areas that need to move a lot, like joints, and fewer in stable areas. Also think about how the model will be used, like for animation or static displays. Should I retopologize or just reduce poly count for a first-time animation of a sculpted character? If the animation is not complex, reducing the poly count might suffice. However, for practice and better results, learning retopology is beneficial as it will provide a cleaner, more animatable mesh. Why is there no AI doing the retopology for me? Hold on, this is a rabbit hole. Developing an AI capable of retopology is challenging and costly because it requires creating advanced mathematical models. Additionally, running AI systems for complex tasks is resource intensive. For example, take the newest fancy shit stable diffusion in consideration. Current AI image generators can produce high realistic results, but are limited to relatively small sizes like 512 pixels. This means the AI is estimating 262,144 data points for a single 2D image. Now, when we shift from 2D to 3D, the complexity increases exponentially. To generate a 512-point cube in 3D, the AI must handle approximately 134 million points. Considering an AI like Midjourney takes around 30 seconds to generate a 2D image, a comparable 3D task could take upwards of 4.5 hours. This is an immense amount of computation, often exceeding the time it would take to retopologize manually. I know this is comparing apples with oranges, since stable diffusion is meant for 2D image generation, but it gives us a rough overview of the complexity when it comes to the 3D space compared to 2D. Furthermore, retopology is not merely about plotting points. It involves creating an efficient and functional edge flow and establishing the right connections between vertices, adding another layer of complexity. Therefore, until the economic incentives align, that is, until the retopology market grows to a scale where billions of dollars are at stake, the motivation to develop such specialized AI may remain limited. Next one. Why would one start with a detailed sculpt only to retopologize it later instead of starting with a base mesh? Starting with a detailed sculpt allows for creative freedom without worrying about topology, but it always depends on the object and your preferred workflow. Making game assets like a shield or a sword is easy by just modeling and putting details on a multi-resolution modifier, whereas creating organic objects like humans is much easier in sculpt mode. How to add sculpting details on your retopologized geometry? You can either use the multi-resolution modifier and sculpt on top of it, or if you already have a detailed model, bake the details on a normal map. How do you keep details like scales and small wrinkles in a model during retopology? You don't keep them. The goal of retopology is to get rid of them and transfer the details onto textures. How do you maintain even polygon distribution, especially when certain areas like the nose and ears require more detail? It's okay to have areas with more detail and a higher number of polygons. Retopology's aim is to create a mesh that works best for its purpose, not about winning a beauty contest. How many polys should I aim for? Short answer? As much as you need. Long answer? The number of polygons you need depends on various factors like the performance of the device the model will be used on. For a detailed discussion and benchmarks, refer to the linked video in the description. How can retopology be made suitable for joint topology, especially for areas like shoulders, knees, and elbows? That's a pretty interesting question. We simply have to play the surgeon a little here. The easiest way is to find 4 quarts and cut them using the knife tool, like so. How to fix bad topology in a 3D model? Depends. Look for angons or triangles that could be problematic, remove unnecessary edge loops, or if it's really messed up, just retopologize it. How does retopology influence the UV unwrapping process? Retopology greatly affects UV unwrapping by defining edge loops that will later be selected for seams. Ensure you have logical edge loops separating different parts where you want to add seams later. How do you ensure that the mesh does not shrink or lose volume after applying retopology modifiers like shrink wrap or subdivision? When using modifiers like shrink wrap, make sure your target mesh is properly set up to avoid shrinking. With subdivision, keep the original volume by strategically placing additional geometry where needed or use creasing. Is there a finalization step for a retopologized mesh before rigging or weight painting? The only thing I do after retopology is to apply the modifiers and check and fix the normals. After retopology, is the model ready for texturing or are there any other steps? Yes, you have to UV unwrap your model. For a character model after remeshing, which model do you use for rigging and texturing? And can the original sculpt be deleted? The retopologized mesh is used for rigging and texturing. The original sculpt can be kept for baking details or discarded if no longer needed. I always keep them in case I want to create variations of my model and use the sculpt as a base. How do you properly connect separate pieces of topology? Learning how to transition from one edge to multiple edges and back is crucial. Use these techniques to smoothly connect different parts of a single object during retopology, or if you're working with multiple parts, they don't always need to be connected. Does retopology affect the weight painting? Yes, it does. The better the topology, the better the weights can be distributed, making deformations look much better. Can retopology impact the final render time of a 3D model? Yes, it's one of the main factors for rendering time. What is the best approach to retopology for a model that may require future sculpting adjustments, especially regarding clothing, armor, and accessories? Try to complete your sculpting before retopology as much as possible. If you need to adjust shapes after retopology, you can use sculpting tools, but only for minor changes to avoid distorting the mesh too much.
How to fill faces quickly is shown in...
Place a video timestamp here. You can press F to connect two edges or vertices, bridge edges to connect multiple edges, or use grid fill to fill in full sections. What are loop tools and how do they work for retopology? Loop tools is probably the most useful add-on when it comes to 3D modeling or retopology in Blender. It allows you to perform different actions on your topology. The space function, for example, distributes vertices evenly, and the relax function can help you to create smooth topology. In the retopology process, should the shrink wrap modifier be applied before using other tools like space from loop tools for smoothing? Sometimes, shrink wrap acts on the original mesh, so it can cause side effects. If spacing looks wrong, turn off shrink wrap, check the points, and if they're not right, apply the modifier and edit again. Smooth vertices or the relax function are also affected by this. Is subdividing large quarts faster than creating small quarts from the beginning? Yes, definitely. No matter if you model, sculpt, paint, draw, or retopologize, starting simple is easier. To ensure a nice topology, use the smooth vertices function on the inner vertices after subdividing. What is the purpose of using the shrink wrap modifier in retopology? Shrink wrap helps to match the new mesh closely to the detailed original shape. Why not use the shrink wrap after subdividing for a better mesh snap to the high poly surface? Using shrink wrap after subdividing can give more detail but might not always improve the resulting mesh. Another aspect is that modifiers should be applied in the order they are assigned, so if you are not planning to apply the subdivision modifier, you will have a hard time. Can the smoothing brush in sculpt mode be adjusted to snap to a high poly model? No. I mean, yes, but don't do it. Can shrink wrap modifier alone solve the problem of a retopologized mesh not conforming to the original surface? Yes and no. It's not a one-size-fits-all solution. If there is not enough geometry to wrap the original model, nothing will help you. Are there any recommended add-ons to speed up the retopology process? There are many, from automatic ones to simple helpers. I prefer to retopologize with Plain Blender and the Loop Tools add-on. But to name a few, Retopoflow, Quad Remesher, Topogon, B-Surfaces, and Blender's own remesh tool. Is manual or automatic retopology recommended for a 3D model that will be animated and used in a game engine? I would go for manual retopology for animated models in games due to the need for precise control over edge flow for deformation. Can auto retopology tools produce usable face loops and edge flow for animation? For high quality, probably not, but let's look at an example. How do automatic retopology tools handle complex non-symmetrical shapes like those from photogrammetry? They're okay and can save time, but might need some manual fixes. Where can I find auto retopology tools or functions? For Blender, Quad Remesher is an option, though it's expensive. ZBrush has Z Remesher, which is similar in terms of outcome. What are the performance considerations when using retopology add-ons? It depends on the mesh's complexity and your computer's strength. It could be very quick or cause Blender to stop working if it takes too long. How does manual retopology compare to Quad Remesher add-on for Blender? Manual retopology is better if you need a specific edge flow, for example for animation. Automatic tools like Quad Remesher works for static objects, but might make a heavier mesh than needed. What about topology for animated non-human characters like animals or fantasy creatures? All moving models need careful edge flow, just like humans. How to handle retopology for hair, especially strands made with curves or paths? Hair is tough. Ideally, model it so retopology isn't needed. Otherwise, start over and model it so retopology isn't needed. Is there a way to reproject a finished edge flow to a high poly object without an add-on? Yes, you can use the shrink wrap modifier's project mode for this. Will the retopology process create animation ready topology? I guess not for you, sir. But if done properly, yes. What happens after applying all the modifiers? Someone will knock on your door and you will answer it. And from that moment, no one will ever hear from you again.
But what's the point of retopology if you're going to use modifiers that increase the vertex count?
Good question. A mesh with 1 million polys is more performant if the 1 million polys are created through a modifier. It's about control. With a retopologized model, you can, for example, animate with fewer points for speed and then add more for better visuals for rendering. When subdivision surfacing is applied, it increases the quad count again. How is this practical in retopology? I read this question surprisingly quite often. Why the hell would you do that? Explain, please. Is it okay to have n-gons under the eyes in a character model? No. I understand the need for quads, but why does each face need to be a square? Faces don't always have to be square. Rectangles are fine too, especially when the shape doesn't bend much, like the sides of the nose or the forehead. Is there a difference in using the in front checkbox versus add-ons for mesh visibility in retopology? They both just help you to see your work better. Blender now also has its own retopology visibility toggle in the mesh edit mode menu. What are common pitfalls and solutions when using the extrude function with snapping turned on during retopology? Haha, noob trap. Even today, I still fall for it at least once per retopologized model. If you don't know what I'm talking about, if you extrude an edge loop, for example, and have snapping turned on, the back faces will snap to the front. The solution? Turn off snapping before. Why is retopology perceived as a weakness in Blender? Blender is seen as weaker in retopology because it lacks specialized tools, making user depend on extra add-ons. Why are there only 49 questions in this video? Because the last question is reserved for you. If you still have questions after we've covered the 50 most frequently asked ones, feel free to drop them in the comments and perhaps we will have a part 2 of this video soon.